Now we are going to verify. We are taking an example to verify the Gauss divergence theorem that we have just derived. So using the first of all we have to verify the Gauss divergence theorem using the vector field E vector, which is given over here. The expression of the vector field is given that it is equal to y square I cap plus 2xy plus z square j cap plus 2yz k cap. So there is x component of this vector field and there is y component of this vector field and z component of vector field, and we have to verify this divergence theorem. And the volume that has been given over here is the cube of unit length at the origin. So there is a cube of unit length, that is its side will be equal to 1 unit, and it is at the origin. So it is placed at the origin. So we have to verify the Gauss divergence theorem. We have been given a volume, so there will be a surface area, and we have to verify the Gauss divergence theorem. So Gauss divergence theorem is the surface integral of E vector over the closed surface, and now over here this closed surface is the surface area of the cube that is given, and this is equal to the right hand side we have the volume integral of divergence of E, and this volume, it is the volume which is enclosed by this closed surface, this cube, the volume which is enclosed by this cube, that is we will use that particular volume. So first of all we will evaluate the right hand side. On the right hand side we have the volume integral, so there is no need to write in the subscript V and S, because here we have shown three integrals, which means that it is a volume integral, and over here we have a surface integral, so we have two integrals, which definitely means that it is a surface integration. So divergence, on the right hand side we have this vector. So first of all we will evaluate this vector, because it is quite easy to evaluate this one. So first of all we will find what is divergence of E. So divergence of E, it is given by the formula del Ex by del X plus del Ey by del Y plus del Ez by del Z. So over here we have the partial differentiation. It is not the complete differentiation. It is the partial differentiation. And we have already seen, if we are doing the partial differentiation of any function, so the variable with which we are doing the partial differentiation, only that variable will be taken as a changing variable, and all other variables that are present, no matter there is y, z, k, l, m, any variable, that will be treated as a constant value. So only x will be the variable, and all other alphabets like y, z, k, l, m, they will be treated as the constants. So first of all we will evaluate what is divergence of E. So this will be equal to del by del x of Ex, and Ex the x component of the vector field, which is y square, plus del by del y of Ey, which is the y component of the vector field, and this is 2xy plus z square, plus del by del z of Ez, and Ez is 2yz. So this will be given in the numerical. So on the first term we have del by del x, and there is no variable x, so this will be a constant term, and this will be equal to 0, plus we have over here 2xy plus z square, and we are doing the partial differentiation with respect to y, so only y will be the variable, and all other alphabets they will be constant, that is x will be treated as constant, and z square, this will be also a constant. So we will do the normal differentiation. So treating x and z square as constant, we will do the normal differentiation, and this will be equal to the differentiation of 2xy with respect to y will be simply 2x, plus the differentiation of z square with respect to y, it will be 0, because it is a constant. Then we have the differentiation with respect to z, so z will be treated as a variable and y will be treated as constant, so this will be equal to 2y. So the divergence of E vector, it will be given by 2x plus 2y. And what we have to do, what we have to evaluate is this vector. We have found divergence of E. Now we will find the volume integral of the divergence of E. So this will be equal to volume integral of divergence of E is 2x plus 2y that we have already found times dv. Now dv is the small volume element and dv it can be written as dx times dy times dz. So dv is the small volume element and it can be written in terms of small elementary length, small length, that is dx, dy, dz. So when you will multiply them, that will give you the small volume element. So dv it can be written as dx, dy, dz. And here we will be using the limits of x, y and z. So in this volume in the question we have been given that this is a cube of unit length. So the limits of x, y and z will be from 0 to 1. The limit of x will be from 0 to 1. So at this point it will be a unit length. At this point also it will be a unit length. And at this distance this will also be a unit length. So all the sides of the cubes they are of unit length. This is already given in the question. So the limits of x will be from 0 to 1. Similarly, limits of y will be from 0 to 1 and that of z will be 0 to 1. So these limits they will vary according to the volume that have been given in question. So in our case, we have been given a cube of unit length. So the limits of x, y and z will be 0 to 1. So first of all, we will do the integration. So first of all, we will do with respect to x. Then we will do with respect to y, then we will do with respect to z. So this integral it will be equal to, so first integral will remain as it is, second integral will remain as it is. Now third integral, this integral is over x. Now here we have written dx. So first of all this integral, the innermost integral, this is over x. So we will evaluate this. So we will get, here we have 2x. So this integration of 2x, it will be equal to 2x square divided by 2 and that will be simply x square. And the integration of 2y with respect to x, it will be equal to plus 2xy. So we are doing the integration only with respect to the x variable. So 2y it will be treated as a constant. And the limits of x, now these are the limits of x, it will vary from 0 to 1. And dy and dz they will remain as it is. The dy, dz they will remain as it is. We have just done the integration over x variable. So now putting the values of x. First of all you will put the upper limit of x. So that will be equal to, these integrals will remain as it is. First of all you will put x is equal to 1 in both the case. So you will get 1 plus 2y. Then you will put x is equal to 0. So that will be simply equal to 0. So we will get this term times dy times dz. Now we will do the integration with respect to y variable. And this integral, the innermost integral is now over y. So now we will do the solve the integration. This will be equal to, first integral will remain as it is. And the second integral we will solve over y variable. So first we have 1. The integration of 1 will be y, then we have 2y, so that will be equal to 2y square by 2, so that will be simply y square. And the limits of y, they go from 0 to 1, and we will get over here, we will be left with only dz variable. So now we will put the limits of y, so that will be equal to, integral will remain as it is. Then putting the value of upper limit of y, that is 1, so 1 plus 1 square. Minus there will be 0 times dz. So this will be equal to 2 times integration of 0 to 1 dz and this is simply equal to z. So this will be equal to z and the limits of z will be 0 to 1. And solving this term this will be equal to 2. So the volume integration of divergence of E over this particular volume that has been given in our question, this volume integration it comes out to be equal to 2. So the right hand side, according to our question, the right hand side this has come out to be equal to 2. Now we have to solve the left hand side and we will see the surface integral over the closed surface of this cube if this also comes out to be equal to 2. And we have to verify this, the left hand side it it really comes out to be equal to the right hand side. Now we will do the left hand side. We will solve the left hand side according to our question. So we have to evaluate this surface integral vector E dot product with ds vector. So we are dividing this whole surface, this closed surface, this is a cube. So there will be total 6 surfaces. There will be left surface on the left side, then the surface on the right hand side, then at the top, then at the bottom, and then the surface at the front and the surface which is at the back side of this figure. So we will do the surface integration. So this is the closed surface integration because here we are given a closed surface. Now we will divide this closed surface into the open surfaces. That is, we will get 6 integrations. We will divide this surface into 6 open integrations. So that will be equal to integral over first surface E dot ds plus integral over second surface E dot ds vector plus integral over third surface E dot ds plus the surface integral over fourth surface E dot ds. Now you can see that here we are writing open surfaces because we have divided a closed surface which is a cube. We have divided it into their individual surfaces. So these surfaces are open surfaces plus fifth surface E dot ds and the last surface which is sixth face E dot ds. Now we will evaluate individual surface integrals and we will sum all those integrals and we will check if the summation of all these 6 surface integral, if this summation it comes out to be equal to 2, because on the right hand side we had the volume integral and volume integral it has come out to be equal to 2. So the left hand side it also should come out to be equal to 2. So now first of all we will evaluate these individual surface integrals. So now we are going to find the surface integral of E vector. So here is the E vector. So it has been rewritten over here. So now we are going to find the surface integrals over all the faces of the cube. Now I have shown over here the front surface which is shown by blue color and the back surface which is shown by pink color. So the first surface, this blue surface, it is the first surface and that shown by the pink color is the second surface or the second face of the cube. So first of all we will evaluate the surface integral over the first surface, that is this front surface. So this integral vector E dot product with ds vector. Now ds vector, that is the area vector. Area vector it is given by the length and the breadth. The magnitude of the area is length times the breadth. But over here, what will be the magnitude of the area vector for the case of blue surface, that is the first surface? So this is the first surface and this is the second surface. So the area vector on the first surface, it will be dz and dy. The variable will be dy and dz. Now you can see on this surface, first surface, x is constant because x has unique value which is 1. So for the first surface, this surface, x is constant at all the points on the surface. So the only variables are y and z. So the y and z, they vary at the points on the first surface. So the area element, that is ds vector for the first surface. So for the first surface, ds vector, it will be equal to dy times dz because x is constant. So it is like length times length. So dy times dz times the vector, times its unit vector. So now the unit vector of the ds vector for the first surface. So the surface area vector, it is always pointed in the perpendicular direction and it is pointed outside the volume or outside the figure. So this vector of the surface I surface, that is the first surface, the area vector, it will be pointed in the plus x direction. So you can see from the figure that the area vector of the first surface, it will be pointed in this direction, and this direction is the x direction, or you can say the area vector, it will point out of the paper, and that axis is the x axis. So ds vector for the first surface, it will be equal to dy into dz, because x is constant, times I cap. So this will be the area vector, small elementary area vector for the first phase. So for the first phase, E vector dot ds vector. So ds vector is over here, dy into dz for the first surface, times I cap. So this is the area vector for the first surface. And now we are doing the dot product of area vector and the vector field. And in the vector field, we have three components. But in the vector, area vector, we have only the x component. So when you will do the dot product of E vector with this vector, so you will be just left with the y square term. So the y component and the z component, they will vanish, because there is no other j cap component and k cap component in the area vector. In the area vector, what we have is only I cap component, that is the x component. So when you will do the dot product, in the dot product, what we do is we multiply x component with the x component, plus we multiply y component with the y component, plus we multiply the z component with the z component. But over here, there is only x component. So this will be equal to surface integral, and we will just use the x component. This will be equal to y square times the x component of the area vector, which is dy into dz. So this will be the simplification of this integral. Now what will be the limits of y and z? Since at this first surface, x is constant, x is equal to 1 at this surface. At the first surface, x remains constant, and that is equal to 1, because this is the upper limit of 1. This is the upper limit of x. And dy and dz, they will vary from 0 to 1. So the variation of dy, it is also from 0 to 1, and variation of dz, this is also from 0 to 1. So you can evaluate this term. First of all, you will do the integral with respect to y variable. So what you will get, it will be equal to 0 to 1. Then we will get y cube divided by 3, and y limits will be from 0 to 1, and dz, it will remain as it is. So from here you will get 1 by 3. And then when you will do the integral with respect to z, so then you will get equal to, so from here we will just get 1 by 3 integral of 0 to 1 dz. So this will be simply equal to 1 by 3 z, and the limits of z goes from 0 to 1. So this will be simply equal to 1 by 3. So the surface integral of the vector at the first surface, that is at the front surface, it will be just equal to 1 by 3. Now we will do the surface integral over the second surface, which is the back surface. So the area vector for the second surface, it will be pointed outwards, and that will be inside the page. So the area vector, I repeat, the area vector of second phase, it will be pointed in the perpendicular direction, but it will be pointed outside the object. So outside the object means it will be pointed inside the paper, or you can say it will be pointed in the minus x direction. So I cap, it will be, here we had I cap, but for the second phase it will be minus I cap, and the magnitude of the area element will remain dy into dz, because at this back surface also x is constant, because x is equal to 0 at all the points of this pink surface which is shown. Only the variable is y and z, so the area will be dy into dz times minus I cap. So on evaluating, putting the value expression of E vector, which is y square I cap, and all these components, the only component that will remain is just the x component. So this will be equal to 0 to 1, because the limits of y and z, they will again be from 0 to 1, and z will vary from 0 to 1. So we will have y square, now we will have minus of y square over here, times dy into dz. So on evaluating this integral, you will get minus 1 by 3. So the integral will be same as that of before, but we have over here minus sign. Now we are doing the integral, surface integral over the third surface. And the third surface is this shown by the blue color. So this is the third surface. And then we will do the surface integration at this left hand side face, which is the fourth surface. So when we will do the integration over the third face, E vector dot product with what will be the area element? So at this face, what is constant? Y will be constant, because at this y is equal to 1 and all the points at this surface y will be constant. So ds vector for the third face will be dx into dz. So x and z will vary at this surface, and the direction of the area element will be pointed in this direction. So means the area vector for the third surface, it will be plus j cap. So this will be equal to dx into dz, because y is constant, and j cap. So now we will be looking for the j component, the y component of E vector, which is 2xy plus z square. So on evaluating the dot product, you will get 2xy plus z square, which is the y component of E vector, times dx into dz, it will remain as it is. And the limits of x and z, what will be the limits of x and z? From 0 to 1 and 0 to 1. Now in this surface, we have seen that y is constant, and what is the value of y? It is equal to this limit, which is equal to 1. So y will be equal to 1 in this case. So in this case, y will be 1. So y over here, you can put y is equal to 1. So this integral, it will be equal to 0 to 1, 0 to 1 integral, then 2x plus z square, because we have put y is equal to 1. Because for third phase, y is remaining constant, times dx into dz. So you can evaluate this integral. First you will evaluate over x, then you will evaluate it over z. So on evaluating this integral, it comes out to be equal to 4 by 3. So you can solve this integral. First you will do the integration over x, then you will put the limits of x, then you will do the integration with respect to z variable, and then you put the limits of the z variable. So that will come out to be equal to 4 by 3. Similarly, you will do the integration over the fourth surface. And for the fourth surface, this surface, the area vector y will be equal to 0 in this case. For this surface, y will be equal to 0 at all the points. The variable will be x and z. So the area vector will be dx into dz. And it will be pointed in the minus y direction. That is, it will be pointed in minus j cap. And in this integral, or at this surface, y is equal to 0. Earlier y it was equal to 1 at all the points on the surface. Now y is equal to 0 at all the points on the fourth surface. So you will evaluate this integral. So minus it can be taken outside, and the limits of x and z are 0 to 1, 0 to 1, and E vector. And you can put the, you can evaluate this dot product. So here we have j cap, so only the y component will remain of E vector. So this will be 2xy plus z square into dx into dz, it will remain as it is. So y is equal to 0 over here. So you will put y is equal to 0. So this will be equal to 0 to 1 integration minus 0 to 1. Then the first term will vanish. You will just get z square dx into dz. So this will be the integral. And when you will evaluate this, you will simply get it equal to minus 1 by 3. So you can evaluate this, you will get it equal to minus 1 by 3. So we have done the integration. So far we have done integration over four surfaces. First surface, we got the integration is equal to 1 by 3, then minus 1 by 3, then 4 by 3, then minus 1 by 3. Now we are left with the top and bottom surfaces. So at the fifth surface, when you will do the integration, so at the fifth surface, this surface, the area vector will be along k cap. It will be pointed along k cap. And what will be the magnitude of the small area element? At this surface, z will be constant. Z is equal to 1. So only x and y will vary at this surface. So the area vector will be dx into dy, and the direction will be k cap plus k cap. So this you can evaluate. So now you will be using only the z component of vector e, because here we have k cap. So this will be equal to 2yz, which is the z component of the vector, 2yz into dx into dy, they will remain as it is, and x and y, they will vary from 0 to 1 0 to 1, and at this surface z is equal to 1. So here we will put z is equal to 1 for the fifth surface. So this will be equal to 0 to 1 0 to 1 2y, we have put z is equal to 1, times dx into dy. So you can evaluate this integral. So this will come out to be equal to simply 1. And the last surface integral is over the sixth surface. And at this surface, this is the sixth surface, which is the bottom face. At this surface, the area vector will be pointed in the minus k cap direction. So it will be equal to dx into dy, and z will be equal to 0 in this case. At this lower surface, z is equal to 0. At all the points, only x and y, they are varying. So dx into dy times minus k cap. So this will be equal to 0 to 1 integration, 0 to 1 times we will have 2yz, and minus will be taken outside because of this minus k cap, times dx into dy. So here we have z is equal to 0. At this sixth surface, z is equal to 0. Therefore, when you will put z is equal to 0, this whole term will vanish. So on the earlier we had done the volume integration, and the volume integral of the divergence of E, it came out to be equal to 2. And this is the left hand side that we have got. So now we will do the summation of all the surface integrals. So let's do the summation. 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 we will get. So they will cancel with each other. And 4 by 3 minus 1 by 3, that will just be equal to 3 by 3. So that is equal to 1. So this will give us 0 result. This will give us equal to 1. And 1 plus 1, that will give you equal to 2. So the summation of the surface integrals of the E vector over all the surfaces of the unit cube length, that will be equal to, so this surface integral, this will be vector E dot ds vector, this comes out to be equal to 2 in this case also, which is in turn equal to the divergence, volume integral of divergence of E, it also came out to be equal to 2. So this is how we verify the Gauss divergence theorem for this particular vector, and considering the volume to be a cube of unit length.